This is just awesome. It's probably my last chance to photograph these autumn colors. Like, I mean, I reckon 1 week and all these leaves will be gone. It's, as you can see, there are very few now. I think, yeah, I just hope I can get some beautiful colors today. And also the reason why I went out was because when I woke up this morning, I looked out the window down at the farm and I could just see on the hill top, it was like full of mist and fog, and ooh, this is just like, I can't stay inside when it's weather like this. Like, look that direction. Let me try to see if I can show you. Let me just turn on the live view. Yeah, look at this. Just so you can get a feeling of what I'm looking at. Do you see how nice it is? That's this landscape over there. I mean, this is perfect. So I've been here for a little while now and photographed this beautiful scenery, and now I have a little surprise for myself in the camera bag. I drew past the bakery on the way to here, so yeah, and in my camera bag I actually have a little surprise for myself, and I think I'm just going to make a few more pictures here, and then I'm going to find a nice place where I can sit there. And I'm going to experiment a little today. I'm going to do a little landscapes, and I'm also trying to, the reason why I brought the tripod was because I want to when we get a little when it gets a little darker, I want to experiment with doing long exposures while I'm moving the camera to get like some crazy effects, that's kind of to strengthen the expression of this mystery scenery. Yeah, so it's going to be a lot of fun today, and a lot of play, and just a cozy time here in the forest. So, it's definitely time for a cup of coffee now. Everything, it's not raining, and but it's, I don't know, you probably can't hear it, but it's the sound of all these raindrops dripping down from the leaves, hitting all the leaves, the dead leaves here in the forest. And it's just really, really nice. As you can see, or as you probably saw, I have a different lens on today. I haven't been using this lens for, I think, 2 years. It's a Nikon 70-300mm. The reason why I'm using that is because my Tamron 150-600 is, I don't have it. It's sent back to repair because, you know, I had these issues in Scotland. The autofocus didn't work, and sometimes there was just an error with the lens and the autofocus motor would just spin around. So yeah, I called the the place where I got the lens, and they would send it to repair, and then hopefully I'll get it next week with an explanation on what was wrong. And furthermore, I asked them, like, how weather sealed is weather sealed when Tamron writes weather sealed, like, what is there a standard certification, or like, what is it, so that we know exactly how hard we can use this this equipment, because it's an awesome lens, I love it, but it's just not nice when it kind of fails when you're in the middle of a trip or something. It kind of, yeah, it's not a good feeling. So I'm looking forward to share that with you. I will definitely share what was wrong with the lens, and I'll also share their answer about the weather sealing. So now it's the Nikon 70-300 that's on my camera. I like that as well, and I think it's actually good for this. I don't know if you saw that, but I have some presets on the Nikon D5, one for wildlife and one for landscape, so I can quickly change or switch between them with the autofocus performance and the way the camera is just set up. But let me find a place. Apparently I can't talk and find a place at the same time, so let me find a place for a cup of coffee and a piece of bread. That was a surprise. From the bakery, and then I'll tell you a little about these how I set up this menu, or just very short, because this is the same place I had coffee when we I think it was a bird. I think I'll just talk a little more quiet, because even though this is a landscape trip, you never know. We have tried it before to be out here, and then suddenly something happens. Okay, this is the same place. I was having coffee when the fox ran over the road down there. Oh, that was an amazing day. I remember I walked here, and then you see in the background. Do you remember that? When the little fox just. Okay, let's have a cup of coffee, and then let me tell you about the menu, and let me tell you about what we are going to do today, or what I'm going to do today. I brought this just in case, the 600. And now it's time for this. This is really good. Warm coffee, a little milk, definitely my favorite. I know there's a lot of people here in Denmark complaining about now it's autumn and all the warmth is away, and it's getting dark late in the morning and it's getting dark early in the afternoon, and all the leaves are just naked without, and all the trees are naked without leaves, and everything is wet and rainy and misty. But I mean, everything I just mentioned, I really, really love. I think it's amazing. I mean, I just love the fact that here in Denmark we have the four seasons, and if it's a good year, we have the winter with snow. It's not so often, but then we have the early spring, you know, all the green colors, they come and all the life begins again. And then summer, where everything is like totally green and all the flowers and all the spiders and all the insects and stuff, and all the animal babies are getting bigger. And then just when you're used to everything is green, it's getting like everything changes to like this colorful pattern all over, and you just go crazy with the camera. And then now, I mean, now it's just going into such a hibernating state. I don't know if you can say that, but it's like everything goes to sleep. It feels like nature is settling down, but it's so peaceful out here and so nice. And yeah, I really, really like it. No, just want to talk short about my settings, custom setting bank in the Nikon. And it's the same on Canon. You have it's just named something else. But I mean, I'll probably do a photographer's Friday. I will do a photographer's Friday about it. It's just, I think it's very useful. Like, and there's so many elements in it that can have a photographer's Friday for themselves. And I don't want to go through it now. I just talk about the basics, because what I use these custom menu banks for, so like that I can quickly change between like a range of settings without having to go into all of them. Because sometimes I use autofocus on my release finger, that's like 95% of the time. But when I do landscapes and more creative photography, I use back button autofocus. And I know there's a lot of like opinions about one another, but I think I have found what I like the most here. And another thing is like things like exposure delay mode, things like what is called first electronic curtain something, I don't know what it's called, but I have that in one menu, custom menu bank and custom setting. What is it called? It's called custom setting bank. I have one called wildlife and one called landscape. And with the wildlife, I have the autofocus on my index finger, and on the landscape, I have the autofocus on the other one. And there's a whole range of settings in the two different banks. And then I can, with one of my custom buttons here, I can just press and turn the wheel, and then I'm using the other one, like landscape or wildlife. And usually I'm never in a hurry when it's landscape, so I have the time to change. But when suddenly something happens, I need to be able to go quickly into all these settings that are related to wildlife photography. But as I said, I want to do a Photographer's Friday about that. And I also want to do a Photographer's Friday about using back button autofocus versus using the normal mode. I've put the 70-300 on, and I have the 600 just in case. And I just want to be here for a little while, relax, have a cup of coffee, have my bread, and then just basically walk around and see what I can find, and just let me get inspired about what I see. And then maybe I can show you a good picture at some point. Maybe I cannot, but no matter what, this is amazing. think I want to photograph this. It's really it's difficult, but I think all landscape photography is difficult. No. I like how the leaves are falling down from the trees when the wind comes. And I'm thinking about what would happen if I made a long exposure with the leaves coming down. Would I get these leaves? I think it's worth a try. As you can see, first I'm walking in one direction and then I'm walking in another direction because I don't really know what I want. I don't know. Do you know that feeling when you sometimes you just feel so inspired about something and other times you don't? And right now, even though it's nice, I don't feel inspired at all. So, and I think I've experienced that when I have this feeling, as no, it doesn't help to just push through it and start to press the release button, because nothing good comes out of it, usually for me at least. So what I'm going to do now is put my camera in my camera bag and just walk around until I find something that makes me a little excited about what I see and what I feel. So I tend to do that instead of just going around and photograph everything, put the camera away, just walk around, have a nice trip and then see what happens. So that's what we're going to do now. It's raining and you see, I don't know if the raindrops are hitting the lens. No, not really, but the light is getting weak now very fast, and it's time to make up my mind, because otherwise I'll not get anything it is beautiful here, but I have just something, like I have other things in mind. I want to find a location where I can really see this mist, and I think I have a location in mind. So it might be my last chance today to get a good photo or capture that. I think it's my last chance now. It is so difficult because I'm attracted to the mist, so I want to get in between the big trees. But at the same time, I'm really attracted to all the colors. So I'm split between two things, and it's not like one location is here with the colors. The other location is further away, and that is where the big trees are, where I can maybe photograph the mist. And I think I've made up my mind, and I know exactly where to go before it's getting too dark. So yeah, I'm packing the equipment, and see you in this new location. So this is my last chance to get one of these photos I really want. And I think this is perfect because now I'm in the pine forest, or what it's called. And I'm now walking out to the beech forest, where it's much more light, and the contrast is, you see behind me, the contrast is because there's no light coming down through the trees. The trees are standing on, I don't know what it's called, but they are so dark. But look in front of me, that's a beech forest. It's much less contrasty. It's really nice, and this is exactly what I'm going to photograph. I really, really like this. I mean, it's getting dark so fast right now, and it's like the fog is starting to disappear a little bit, and that's because it has actually started to rain, because the temperature has dropped a few degrees, so I have to be quick now and just work with the last light for maybe 10 or 15 more minutes, and I think that's it then. Oh, I think it's getting really good. I just like this. Try to look here. So, just have to see, it's really nice, just a few of the photos, a little darker. I like this one, it's a little more mystery. This one, see, what else did we get? Ooh, yeah, so it's really nice to photograph here. Unfortunately, it's just getting dark very, very fast. What I want to do now before I go home is to play with the very low light. Instead of like working against it and try to like crank up the ISO, which can also be nice, I just want to try to make some like 5-second exposures here, and then move the camera, like leave the camera for maybe 4 seconds and then move it for 1 second, just to see if I can get some dramatic effects here. But yeah, I think that'll be my last little project this evening. And unfortunately, I didn't get a lot of these very vibrant, beautiful colors, but I was just overwhelmed by the mist and all this. So anyway, I'm looking forward to see what I actually got. I saw them on the camera, but I'm looking forward to see them on the screen. But yeah, it's I think it's playtime, and then it's coffee time, and then it's go home time. So yeah.